Hello and welcome to Socioaquatic, a one-stop destination for SSLC Social Science. Do you wish to score well in exams? Then you are at the right place. So without any delay, let's get started.
Hello friends, I'm Prashant Kumar. Oh, Gandhi. Gandhiji means immediately what you remember. Yes, you are right. Satyagraha, ahimsa, or non-violence. And Gandhi created a new model of struggle in the Indian freedom movement. And it is known as Gandhian way of struggle. See, he created his own style of fighting against the British. So he entered into Indian freedom struggle in 1920 up to 1947. This time period between 1920 to 1947 is called as the Gandhian era, era of Gandhi. Yes, friends, today let us discuss about the eighth lesson of history of 10th standard social science, era of Gandhi and national movement. Yeah, Gandhiji, his early life. As you know, Gandhiji was born on 22nd October 1869 in Porabandar. His parents were Karamchand Gandhi and Putali Bai. So that's why his full name, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. And actually, he was influenced on moral values more from his mother Putali Bai. And after completing his basic education at Porbandar, he completed his bar at law in England. He went to England in 1888 for a higher education in law. And afterwards, after completing his law, he went to Natal of South Africa to represent Dada Abdullah and Company. For that case, he went there. And he opposed apartheid with the new tool called Satyagraha. There in South Africa, he started his movement. He started to oppose this discrimination based on color, apartheid, suppressing of one section of the society by the another section, which was opposed by him. Actually, you know that story, when he was traveling by train, a white person, he kicked him out. From there, he started that. And now we have to discuss about another point, that is initial protest of Gandhiji. As per the instructions of his political guru, Gopalakrishna Gokhale, Gandhiji's political guru, Gopalakrishna Gokhale, as per his instruction, Gandhiji too entered India in a third class railway compartment. So we have to travel to get knowledge and we have to read books. These are the two ways we have to get knowledge. So Gokhale told to travel in the third class railway compartment to know the condition of the common people. There he understood the problems of farmers, Dalits, tribal people, workers, laborers, and other sections of the society. And then he established his Sabarmati ashram at Ahmedabad. Yeah, in 1916 he established this Sabarmati ashram, and he launched Champaran movement to support indigo growers in 1917. So one by one his protest started for the farmers, this one. and started a movement to support mill workers of Ahmedabad in 1918, opposed land tax at Kheda village. So all this for farmers and mill workers, laborers, employed passive resistance, non-violence and satyagraha as the strategies. His strategy is that one, satyagraha, non-violence, passive resistance. And he expressed his thoughts in periodicals like Young India and Harijan. So these are the two periodicals he started. Through that he expressed his ideas. And here the Gandhi's method, there are two words we will get, satyagraha and ahimsa. Here satyagraha means assertion of the truth, or it is a non-violent passive resistance. Whatever they do, we will not hurt them. If they beat to one side of our cheek, we will show the another. So like that. And another one, ahimsa, non-violence. We don't want to hurt others. We don't want to kill others. So that was the speciality of Gandhiji. And saying very easy, following very difficult. Gandhiji is an ideal. He's an ideal. Ideal means we can't reach that in such a position. Okay. And another idea of Gandhiji, here he wanted to unite Hindus and Muslims. And he understood that this is the only method we can improve India. By achieving unity between Hindus and Muslims, it is possible to improve India. Otherwise, not possible. If these two communities quarrel each other, definitely India will not improve. He tried till the end of his life to bring unity between Hindus and Muslims. So, during Khilafat movement, he supported the Muslims. Their Ali brothers, they started. So for them he supported. So this is the initial protest of Gandhiji. Next important one we have to see, Jallianwala Bagh massacre. Actually, if you visit there in Jallianwala Bagh, definitely we get hurt or tears will burst. Such a situation. We can pictureize that in our eyes. And the British implemented Rowlatt Act in 1919. So against this Rowlatt Act, actually through this Rowlatt Act, British started controlling the nationalists. And under this act, they can arrest anyone. And they can arrest a man and declare him as offender in a court of law. Without any notice, they can arrest and they can declare him as an offender. So against this, Gandhiji started Satyagraha Sabha to oppose this act. Gandhiji called for one day Hartal on 6th April 1919. Dr. Fakhruddin Ali, Dr. Satyapal, etc. were arrested in Punjab. To protest this, people had assembled in Jallianwala Bagh on 13th April 1919 on the day of Baisakhi festival. Baisakhi is a big festival there. Yeah, and in Kerala, etc., they celebrate this, Vishu Sankramana. So, Baisakh is a big festival there. At that Baisakh festival, they assembled at Jallianwala Bagh near Amritsar. Yeah, and there, that place is like this, surrounded, closed area, and only one entrance. At that time, in that area, General Dyer, he came with the army and he decided to attack on these men. There, women, children, age-old people, everyone were there. And he came with the army and he made the soldiers to stand in a row and started firing, ordered firing without any intimation. He came there and ordered for firing there. People were assembled there. They can't go anywhere because one entrance there, soldiers were standing and they are firing from that side. Many people, they tried to climb the wall and the bullets hit on them and they fell down. So there we can see on the walls, now also the wall is there and we can see the marks of the bullets, bullet marks there. In memory of that, they constructed this. And many people died. And there is one dry well. Someone wanted to avoid these bullets and they jumped into the well. One by one they jumped and finally filled that well, is filled with the dead bodies, because one by one everyone, if they jump, those who are below, they will die. See, the very, very bad incident. Inhuman activity. General Dyer did. So nearly 380 people were killed. So this incident angered a person called Udham Singh. Udham Singh got angry and he wanted to take revenge for that. He went to England. And actually, after this incident, General Dyer was honored in England Parliament for his act. See, for killing also honoring. To kill him, Udham Singh went to England. He didn't have that much money. Still, he collected the money and finally he went there. He worked there and was waiting for an opportunity to kill him. And finally, he got an opportunity and killed him in England. Udham Singh, a revolutionary, killed General Dyer in England. That is India. Yeah. So this Jallianwala Bagh massacre, actually the very, very tragic incident which happened in India from the British. Next, Khilafat movement. The sultans of Turkey were also the religious leaders, were called as caliphs. The sultans of Turkey were religious leaders. They were called as caliphs. Muslims opposed the harassment of British on the caliphs. British started to harass caliphs. So Muslims opposed that throughout the world. In India, Ali brothers, Muhammad Ali and Shaukat Ali, they started Khilafat movement. As I told earlier, Gandhiji supported this movement. Okay. And next, non-cooperation movement. The Congress passed the resolution to hold non-cooperation movement in the special national convention held in Calcutta on September 4th, 1920. And there, that session aimed at educating the people about the British for their brutal killing and also preventing Jallianwala Bagh like incidents in future. So this non-cooperation movement started. And what were the main programs in non-cooperation movement? Boycotting schools, colleges and courts. Boycotting elections to regional legislative bodies. Returning honors and medals given by the British. Resigning of nominated members to the local bodies. Boycotting all the government functions. Boycotting all foreign goods. Encouraging handlooms and protecting khadi. See, cottage and small scale industries should be improved. So, open school, national schools, achieve unity among Hindus and Muslims, eradicate untouchability and uplifting the women by empowering them. These were the main programs of non-cooperation movement. Very important question. Long answer question this one. Okay, these were the programs. And during the non-cooperation movement, what were the major developments? That one we have to see. Lawyers like Deshbandhu Chittaranjan Das, C.R. Das, Motilal Nehru, Rajendra Prasad left their legal practice. Students boycotted schools and colleges. Congress boycotted the elections of our local bodies. National institutions like Kashi Vidyapita, Gujarat Vidyapita, Bihar Vidyapita and Jamia Millia Islamia Rashtriya Vidyalaya were established. National schools. Rabindranath Tagore returned his knighthood award. Common people and women donated to the Congress. Shops selling foreign goods were boycotted and foreign clothes were burnt. Swadeshi movement. The visit of Prince of Wales in 1921 was opposed. So these are the major developments under non-cooperation movement. So because of this, what happened? What were the impacts of non-cooperation movement? The freedom movement became people's movement. So that freedom movement reached the common people. Common people also started to participate in it. The Congress-led movement took revolutionary turns. The movements took revolutionary turns here. The Hindu-Muslim unity was temporarily achieved. Temporarily, this Hindu-Muslim unity achieved because afterwards it broke out. The National Freedom Movement went beyond the boundaries of cities and entered into the villages. So it was only in the city, but now it entered into the villages also. In the rural area also, the people started to oppose the British. Attempts to remove untouchability and entry of women into public spaces were started. So these were the impacts of non-cooperation movements. Yeah. Now, why non-cooperation movement ended? Main reason is the Chauri Chaura incident. A police officer had beaten Congress workers when they were protesting in front of an arak shop. They were protesting in front of a arak shop. And they were going at night, actually. They are holding the torch fire and going a procession. While going a peaceful procession, the police, they had beaten these protesters. To protest against this, on 5th February 1922, around 3,000 farmers assembled in front of the police station. So beating of the police officer on the protesters, on 5th February 1922, nearly 3,000 farmers assembled in front of the police station. To send them, police started shooting, firing on from inside the station. Now what happened? When they started firing, immediately the people, the farmers, they got angry. At night it was. They were holding the torch. And they started to attack on the police. The police entered into the police station and they closed the door. And immediately the enraged people torched the police station, resulted in the death of 22 policemen. They burnt alive. These people, they attacked on the police station and burnt it. And Gandhiji's thinking is different. He wanted to bring non-violent methods. He wanted to continue this non-cooperation movement in a non-violent way, but here he opposed this violence. Because of this Chauri Chaura, the place name is Chauri Chaura, and because of this Chauri Chaura incident, Gandhiji was pained and he withdrew the non-cooperation movement. Yeah. So in this way, non-cooperation movement stopped. And Gandhiji was arrested. British holding Gandhiji is responsible for all this violent uprising. So he was arrested. And after 2 years, he was released on the grounds of ill health. So this is about Chauri Chaura incident. Next, still more it is there. Let us discuss about that in the next video. Thank you. Thank you very much.